So with another lockdown on us, and I'm getting bored, so I decided to make another clock mechanism testing stand. Because I made one before, but I didn't film myself making it, and I thought it would be a good idea to show you guys how I've made it, and you could perhaps copy it or improve on it. So I'll give you a quick look around it. I've just used some, it's like an inch thick plywood, which I had laying around. Doesn't have to be inch thick plywood, it's just what I had. I went out and bought a bit of threaded bar. It's like a couple of quid, which is really cheap. And it's all just my own idea and design. So what I did also is I glued a couple of bits of plywood together, then cut out a semicircular shape out of it so that a French clock mechanism can sit in there quite comfortably and nicely. But, and this is the clever bit, if you're doing, say, an American clock, or like I recently did an Ansonia, this block just comes off, and I put grooves in there where you can sit a square mechanism in there, and it holds it just as well. But that's a look around. Now I'll show you how I made it. Okay, so there we are. That's how I made my clock mechanism test stand. That's it. All right, so I made this because I was bored. I had nothing better to do and I fancied making another little YouTube video. And this is now spare. And I've decided to donate it to one of my YouTube buddies, Spencer, who's I've been getting really good advice from him. He's a learner like me. His videos are well worth looking at as well. He knows things that I don't. And I think all of us learners learn from each other. But I noticed that he didn't have a mechanism holder. So, Spencer, this is for you. Get in touch with me and let me know where to send it. Merry Christmas.